Hello, I'm Dr. Greg Williams with Independent Science, and I am here with Aaliyah, a student at the Washington State School for the Blind. In this video, we will be demonstrating how to safely conduct and analyze experiments in the science laboratory without vision. These are techniques that I, Aaliyah, and other people who are blind have successfully used to complete high school and college level science courses. The first technique we will cover is material preparation, an essential part of the lab experience, and extremely important to a student who is blind or has low vision. The student must review and be comfortable with the lab procedure before entering the classroom, as well as being familiar with the layout of both the classroom and the lab. Familiarization with the lab bench setup is necessary to provide a safe experience for the student. A consistent lab bench setup should be decided upon and reviewed prior to beginning any experiment. If working with a partner, there should be open communication about the location of any lab materials. Please refer to our first video, How to Safely Organize and Set Up a Lab Bench, for detailed tips and techniques. No matter what course you are in, virtually every experiment will include the measuring and transferring of liquids and solids between containers. A wide-mouth container reduces the probability of spills. Pouring or scooping into a wide-mouth container is easier for the student, but when a graduated cylinder or small beaker is required, a funnel should be used. As an alternative to the common lab scoop, transferring solids with a teaspoon will minimize the risk of spills. The transfer of any materials should be done over the lab tray. The use of aluminum foil will act as an audible indicator and alert the student to any dropped materials. To demonstrate how these techniques are used in a lab setting, we will measure the effect of salt on the freezing point of water. In this experiment, Aaliyah will add 5 grams of salt to 50 milliliters of water. She will then add ice to the beaker, and using the talking LabQuest and Logger Pro, she will collect the temperature of the solution until it is stabilized. Aaliyah will first use a syringe to measure and transfer 50 milliliters of water from a full beaker to a smaller one. The syringe has been adapted with a metal bracket to stop the plunger at exactly 50 milliliters. For measuring other volumes of liquid, a syringe with notches along the plunger at various volumes can be used. Both beakers should be placed on the lab tray. Aaliyah first submerges the tip of the syringe into the full beaker and pulls the plunger back until it stops at exactly 50 milliliters. She then locates the empty beaker with one hand and places the syringe into it with the other. Finally, she empties the water into the beaker by pushing down on the syringe's plunger. The next step is to measure 5 grams of salt. An electronic balance connected to a computer running WindowEyes and Logger Pro allows Aaliyah to hear the mass announced in real time. First, she places an empty container on the balance and pushes the tear or zero button. She confirms the calibration with the computer by pressing Control, Shift, and S to hear the current sensor measurement announced.
Mass 0.00 g.
Using a teaspoon, she scoops salt into the container on the balance and checks the new mass after each addition by pressing Control Shift S.
Mass 1.06 g.
She repeats this procedure until the mass reaches 5 grams. The aluminum foil underneath the balance will alert her to any salt that was dropped. She then lifts the container and wipes any extra salt off the balance to confirm that she has reached the desired mass.
Mass 5.00 g.
Never put spilled material back into its original container. Now that Aaliyah has measured out her material, using a funnel, she will slowly pour the salt into the beaker of water on the lab tray. She will then stir the solution until she can feel that the salt is completely dissolved. Now that the salt solution is prepared, Aaliyah will place the temperature sensor connected to the talking LabQuest into the solution for an initial temperature measurement.
Temperature 26.2 degrees C.
She will then press the data collection button to begin collection of data.
Collection started.
She then begins to add ice to the solution and uses the temperature sensor to stir it.
0.5.
She continues this procedure until the temperature stabilizes, at which point she ends data collection on the Talking LabQuest. As you may have expected, this temperature is below the normal freezing point of water due to the presence of the salt. The data has now been recorded into a data table on the Talking LabQuest for Aaliyah to review. To analyze the data, it should be imported to the Logger Pro software on a computer using a mini USB cable. A Window Eyes app has been developed to provide accessibility to the Logger Pro software. By using Control Tab, Alia can navigate between the data table and graph panels on Logger Pro. Using the arrow keys, Alia can review the data in the data panel. One of the accessibility features in Logger Pro is the ability to gain a qualitative understanding of the graph using the Audio Trace Graph function, which can be found under the File menu in the Accessibility options. The length of the audio trace can be customized based on the experimental parameters. Logger Pro also has many advanced statistical analysis features that are appropriate for more complex experiments. You have now watched a student who is blind complete a simple lab experiment using adaptive techniques. We hope that these introductory tips prove useful for students who are taking high school and college science courses, and look forward to hearing your success stories. Thank you for joining Independence Science and the Washington State School for the Blind for this science technique demonstration. To read more tips for use in the science classroom, or to find more information about the accessible tools used in this video, visit www.independencescience.com.